Good day, it's Mike, VA3MW from Flex Radio. And in early October 2025, Flex Radio introduced and released SmartSDR version 4. Now, SmartSDR version 4 has a number of changes from our current licensing method, and SmartSDR version 4, or 4.01, when we released it, is totally free for every radio available. So if you're at version 1, version 2, or version 3, it's a free upgrade to version 4. We want everybody to migrate to that version because it's actually easier for us to do maintenance and keep things up and running and just tickety-boo on your radio. So we urge you that if you're at one of those previous versions to take some time to upgrade. And we'll go through that in a minute. Again, it's free. There are new features coming, and I'll talk about the features in a moment, but let's talk about quickly how do you get version 4 installed. And it's no different than any previous version, but you do have to go get it from our website, install it in a PC, or use your Maestro panel like you've done before, or your M panel radio to make that upgrade. Let's have a quick look at how that works. Right. So typically, you would start at www.flexradio.com, select software, SmartSDR, and then down here, SmartSDR for Windows. That's going to take you to this webpage that explains all the features about SmartSDR version 4. SmartSDR version 4 Basic is free for every 6000 and 8000 series radios. It's a no-cost upgrade. It allows us to ensure ongoing stability and making sure that your radio's got the most current and the most optimized radio for that's available. And as time goes on, we actually improve the processes behind the radio to make it run much quicker and faster. Now, there's two other programs available. We'll scroll up a bit. There's SmartSDR Plus and SmartSDR Early Access. Let's start about early access first. Not every customer will want to purchase SmartSDR early access, but if you're somebody who wants to be on the latest software the moment it comes out, and you want the ability to provide us feedback, then please join the early access program. It's $100 more. It will be normally $299, and for the month of November 2025, it's $50 off. It allows all the features that are available today to be active so that you can test them for your model of radio. We'll have a chart to show that. If you're okay to wait a while, 30 days after the early access program starts, we have SmartSDR Plus. It's $100 less expensive than SmartSDR Early Access, typically $199 US, on sale right now for $149, again, until about the end of November. Now, some of the features for your radio will be available right away. Other features will be held back until they go through the early access program because we're inviting the feedback from those customers who purchased early access. So again, if you buy SmartSDR Plus and you load it, it will show some features as grayed out. That will be fixed in probably the 4.1 version that's coming out near the end of November. So here's a quick comparison of prices and Basic. If you are coming from version 1 all the way to version 4, you maintain all the features of version 1. You do not get SmartLink, which came out in version 2, and you don't get access to Multiflex, which came out in version 3. Although you do gain Smart Control, which is a feature if you own a Maestro or an M model. Likewise, if you had already purchased version 2, then you will maintain your access to SmartLink. You will not have access to Multiflex. And if you want to get access to those versions, you will need to purchase SmartSDR Plus in version 4. If you want to enable SmartLink and Multiflex, you do need to buy SmartSDR Plus. They will turn on right away the minute your invoice is paid, and the radio authorizes this immediately as long as your radio is connected to the internet. That means if your radio is plugged into your computer with a single LAN cable, like some people have done, it will not license until you give it access to the internet. There's a couple of ways to do that. You can move the cable over to your router or your switch, your network switch, and allow it to call home. It only takes a minute. You can move it back if you want. If you're really crafty, you can turn on internet connection sharing in Windows. Lots of documents and YouTube videos about how to do that. That will allow the radio access to the internet to call home and finish its licensing. There is no file to download once you purchase SmartSDR Extended Access or SmartSDR Plus. Let's have a look at some of the features here. There are numerous new features. Some of them will be available right away. This chart helps to explain it, and some not right away. The features in red are the ones that do not get released until version 4.1, and you do not have access to those features in SmartSDR version 4.0.1. Some of the features are not enabled right away unless you have purchased the early access program. If you have, you see them right away once the licensing is confirmed. If not, you have to wait until version 4.1 is released about the end of November. You can see here in the chart that if you pick your radio, you look down and you can see if there's an X or green box, what's enabled. The red ones are held back from the SmartSDR Plus users and are enabled right away for SmartSDR Early Access. So let me replay that all back to you. If you want access to all the features today, you need to buy into the SmartSDR Early Access program. It's normally $299, less $50, on sale till the end of November. If you want to save a few dollars, purchase the SmartSDR Plus license, and these features, the remaining features, will be enabled at the end of November when we release SmartSDR 4.1. So how do we get 4.0.1 installed? We're going to click on Download SmartSDR here. That's going to take us to the SmartSDR 4.0.1 page. We're going to download SmartSDR like any other file from the internet by clicking here. We'd like you to then, while this is downloading, please take a minute and look at the release notes. The release notes are right here. Very critical. The release notes are always critical. I know we like to blow through them, but take a moment. The more details are in here. We also suggest that after upgrading and saving your profiles, it never hurts to reset your radio. And there are more information on the release notes above that. More details about the noise mitigation modes, how the DSP modes work, and etc. There's a digital voice keyer and how that works. Enhanced signal clarity, which was very similar to Power SDR beam steering. Noise floor scaling, CW autotune, and a lot more. So please take a minute and look at the release notes while you're downloading SmartSDR 4.0.1. Once it's downloaded, double click on the file in your downloads folder and work your way through installing it to your radio, just like normal. All right, I've got it installed. What's next? How do I get to buying the early access or the SmartSDR Plus program? Well, we have a description here. We're going to upgrade the radio in either case to SmartSDR Basic. We're going to start it, and then I want you to go to the radio settings where we set a number of features. Go to the radio tab, and you're going to click here on Get SmartSDR Plus or Get Smart or Early Access. Don't get both. You only need one or the other. There is no file to upload. It's a automatic thing if your radio is connected to the internet. When you click here, it's going to take you to a purchase page like buying something online. If you're using a Maestro or an M model, very similar story, but you're going to go to the menu and then the radio tab. It's going to come up with a QR code. You're going to scan that with a smartphone or an iPad or a tablet, and that will talk you through purchasing it with your credit card. Once your purchase is complete, it will send us an email. A whole bunch of stuff happens behind the scenes. And then this, in this case, will go to gray, meaning so you can't buy it again. So how do we know if our license is good? It's quite simple. We're going to go to settings and radio setup, and we're going to look at license info And the whole story's here. You can see that my early access license expires on November the 8th of 26. All right, so that's good. Some of you will notice that the turf information has changed. We've made some changes in turf as well. Now I want to play with the features, and we urge you to play with them all. We can just go to DSP and we can enable them. You can turn them all on if you think they're all useful being turned on. I can tell you that's not going to give you a result you like. And if we look over, and so you'll notice that wide noise blanker is missing. We move the wide noise blanker over to the antenna control. All right, so what about a Maestro? Let's have a look there. If you're on an M panel or a Maestro, then you're going to go to menu and then go to radio again. And here is our license info here. And it's, you know, here's my expiration. It's the same thing. So that's good. We'll go back to the main panel. And what if I was on this signal right here? And I just take it and move my VFO. And the way we get there is you're going to touch right here. That'll pop up the menu. And because I'm licensed for all versions, you can click on the one you want to play with. And then you're going to just touch back up in a blank area up here. All right, so what do the new features do? Well, we'll start working on the documentation. We do have a help desk article that explains some of the features. And if you're not sure how to find it, I'm just going to type in Flex Radio, SmartSDR, and Noise. I hit enter. And for me, it was the first story that came up. It's in the help desk. I will put the link here with the video so you can find it. So we wrote this article a couple of days ago. You can read through all the different things that are available with the different noise mitigation. That will help you figure out what works for what thing. They don't work through the entire spectrum. Some require some valid signal. Some get overloaded if there's too much signal, so please keep that in mind. And this document's a very handy couple-page document. You can keep it handy to see what noise might help you out. And again, in the end, if you have any issues with your radio, just doesn't seem to be working right, there's a couple of options. You can just try resetting the radio after you back up your profiles. Search for Flex Radio Reset. It comes right up on Google. If you're really not happy, you can easily downgrade to your previous version, 3.10.15. It takes 2 or 3 minutes. There's no risk. 100%, though, you have to reset your radio once you downgrade. 100%, you have to reset your radio once you downgrade. So it's Mike, VI3MW from Flex Radio. Have fun playing with the new features. I look forward to hearing from you in the Flex community at community.flexradio.com. Feel free to share what works for you and that others can learn from it. Even what doesn't work, we're good with that. 7-3, this is Mike, VA3MW.